So it's a day after the big one show and we're back out tackle testing. But what a weekend it was. I've never seen so much tackle ever. Anyway, here's a quick look at my best five match items at the show. So we're at Nitro and with a man that needs no introduction, national hero, really.
Yeah, yeah.
National treasure.
National treasure, yeah.
I know. But, and you, good
I
to
think
see
same
you.
About you, though, you know.
No, don't.
No, I don't. Seriously, I do, yeah.
Why?
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think so. Before we start, how are you? How's your health?
No, fine, that's good.
Yeah?
I'm aching a bit today because we've been really busy, but my hip is fine. It's to be honest with you, I can't, but I feel like a different person. Honestly, I really
yeah?
do. Yeah?
Yeah,
I feel like
well, that's a
I
good
feel
thing.
Like I'm back to normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that a good...
I don't know if that's good or bad, to be honest with you.
Right, look.
Yeah.
I know that you've had an awful lot
yeah.
of input into these nitro yeah. rods. Marvellous.
Marvellous, yeah.
And tell me, because I know there's a different concept going on here with these
yeah.
rods as well.
Yeah, there
so
is, yeah.
tell me, Tommy, how that works.
Well, it's quite simple, really. When I first joined, when Pascal's asked me to, and Ian asked me to join, I asked if I could do my own range of rods, and they said, you can. It was one of my things that I've always been brought up making rods. And the first thing I did, I changed the rod rings to these lighter, finer ones,
yeah.
which I saw on the barbell rods. So, can I put them on my match rods? And they said, yeah. So we've got lovely, fine rubbers,
yeah.
but the right size for the rod, which makes the rod a little bit lighter.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the actions. And what I've done, I wanted two ranges in a range. So, for example, in the 9 and 10 and 11 foot,
yeah.
I took this light carp, because they're all commercial rods, carp
right.
rods. And I wanted one for carp for winter summer fishing, and I wanted one called light carp for winter fishing.
Yeah.
So in other words, when you winter fish using lighter hooks, smaller hooks, and you're looking for the fish, you want something a bit lighter, so that's where the light carp comes in. And then in the summer,
you need a bit beefier.
You want something a bit beefier,
yeah.
and so it's like two rods.
Yeah, but you can stay in the range.
So you can stop in the range. So you've got the 9, 10, 11. For example, I've been fishing, you know, at winter with light carp.
Yeah.
As soon as it gets warmer, I'll change to carp.
Yeah.
Unless I go skimmer fishing, then I'll use a light carp. Because they're perfect for that style of fishing.
And they're not the most expensive rods either,
well,
are they?
Well, I think they're all £110. I mean, that's one thing about our brand is, you know...
So £110, just be honest, you can spend...
Yeah.
Three times that to buy
three
one
times.
Rod.
And when you look at them, they'll look expensive. I think that, you know, they look nice quality and everything. And Pascal's done a, you know, he's done a lovely matte finish on them and everything like that.
Yeah, it's a nice finish.
But it's the actions that are more important to me. And also the tips, we took some finding because I'm really fussy about tips.
Yeah.
And I wasn't happy with the tips that we originally had. And he found a different supplier and it made a massive difference. And they're all coded, so you know which they are. And I think they go from 3/4 ounce to 2 ounce, and you can buy the tip separate. I think you get 2 or 3.
Yeah, it's quite a fast tapering tip, that.
Yeah,
as
it
well.
Is. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So it's gonna, it's like.
But, it's yeah, gonna, basically, yeah.
Yeah.
But they're made for you know, for carp fishing
yeah.
and skimmer fishing, basically, on commercials. The commercial rods.
So in the
9, 10, and 11, there's two of them.
Yeah.
And then we've got a series of all-rounders. Now, what we mean by that is you can go on canal, you can go on a river, you can go on a still water, and just have one rod. So the people that just want one rod, they go for these.
A three-piece.
I like three-piece rods in 11, 12, and 13.
Yeah, we've discussed that before.
Yeah, not everybody does, but I do. I think you get a different action. I think it's different.
I think, like you've travelled like the world in your career fishing, I think you learn that a three-piece rod on a feed rod will give you a better cast in action anyway.
Well, it gives you, it bends through the top splice
yeah.
when you're three-piece, with two-piece don't. So in other words, if I went on a river, probably river fishing, sometimes two-piece are better because it's all tippy.
Yeah.
But I like rods that are throw action. Makes
yeah.
a big difference.
Especially at
not
12.
Not everybody, I get that. But
I think at 12 foot, I think you're absolutely
yeah.
right.
And we do them in 11, 12 and 13. And they're just called an all-rounder. You get different, you know, different tips, but they're three-piece. So if I just want one rod for all my fishing,
yeah.
I just have an all-rounder.
All right, what's your favourite? I don't want to put you on the spot, but if you had to pick one, if I said, right, Tommy, you can have one of these rods... and you've got to make do with it for the year. Which one are you going for?
Me 11 foot light carp.
Light carp 11
foot?
The
10 and 11 foot light carp are the best rods I've ever used. And I've used some.
That's quite a thing to come out
no,
with.
No, and I mean that, Jen. People might think, you know, but that 10 and 11 foot light carp are just out of this world. They're fantastic. You know, anybody that's thinking about getting, they need to look at them too.
Right. Well, Tommy, thank you for that.
Remember what I told you last year?
Go on then, do it again.
The future is nitro.
This is the Shimano pole alley, and I'm not with any old angler. I have the mighty Nick Speed with me.
Right.
How are you, mate?
Nice to meet you.
Have you been touching them pellets again?
Yeah.
I knew you were. Yeah. Right, so what we got here then? What we got?
Well, let me tell you the story. Of course, from last year, X5, X7, and of course the Pro, we had to widen the range. So now we've introduced into the aero range of poles the X3, which is 14.5 metres, the X2, 13 metres, and now the X1, 11.5 metres, and we've also introduced into the range the Margin Aero Power Pole.
Right.
And the Aero Pro Margin Pole as well. But let's talk in a little bit more detail about these three beauties.
Do you want me to sit down?
Yes, please.
Right. Yeah. Like an old man. Right.
So, let's start with the 11.5 metre X1. Now, to be honest with you, for the price point,
yeah,
it's just simply incredible. So well balanced, it's strong, and we wanted to create a pole that ticks all the boxes for all styles of fishing, and especially commercial fishing. And it's such a great start-up pole for the price bracket as well.
Yeah, it feels pretty strong
really
as well.
Really strong. Yeah. And the story runs right through with Shimano Aero poles, strength, reliability, authority.
So I'm looking at them, I'm saying that these three poles, the 1, 2, and 3, are probably a generic mandrel.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes, that's right.
Well, that's handy.
Yeah.
Right,
all
so
interchange, and also, Mark, all the top kits interchange throughout the whole range as well.
Yeah, I think that's quite important, to be
honest,
these
days. Really important. Then we've got the X2.
So basically, we're just going up, sort of
moving up.
We're just moving up lengthwise, aren't we?
But for the price point, the balance in all the poles is simply incredible. So this is a 13-metre pole, again, really strong and ticks all the boxes of what we look for when you're buying a pole for, especially commercial fishing.
Yeah, I think these days, I mean, I see quite a lot of poles, but also writing about poles, and when I go fishing, 13 metres has become, I know sort of international rules, but forget that. I think for commercials, 30 metres is probably the length that gets used more than 100%. Anything else. So you don't, I mean, much as a pro kind of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Something like this is probably, I mean,
if you want to learn how to feed with a catapult, fish your rig efficiently, be in control, 13 metres is the starting point. I mean, 11, that, 13 metres.
Yeah, I mean, that's quite,
it's lovely.
Yeah.
That's really responsive.
Yeah, that's very good.
And then we've got the X3. So it's just under £1,000, this 14.5 metre pole. Package is brilliant for the price point as well.
What I'm looking at, is that the same aero joint?
Exactly.
It's used on
everything
on the Pro?
Is in the same. It's all uniform throughout the whole range. Aero joint. You've got all the specification of a top end pole in a pole under £1,000.
So you've got aero joint in as well. So what's this 14?
Four. That's at 13.
13.
Then we slide this in.
All right.
What do you think?
I think I can't believe how good poles are.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
For their price now. Yeah. And the fact is that, I mean, something like this not that long ago would have cost you like
a lot of money. A lot of money.
I mean, it's just like
incredible.
It's come on so far. And that feels really tough as well.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
I mean, it's definitely an all-round pole, isn't it? Mm.
Oh, God, yeah. I mean, I've tested it on natural waters as well as commercials, and it's just literally ticked the boxes.
It came apart nicely as
well. Yeah, lovely. Yeah, lovely. So, they're the three poles. Let's talk about the margin poles.
Yeah, let's talk about that one before we talk about that one.
Yes.
Because I've seen this.
Yes, okay. So, we've got the Pro Margin. Now, the beauty about this is it's on the same mandrel as the X5, the X7, and the Pro.
Okay.
It's £500.
Oh, my God.
It's incredibly light. It's incredibly strong. It's rated up to a 20 elastic. And also, it's compatible with the X5, X7, and Pro. So, you can actually use this as not only a margin pole, but a spare pole in case anything happens.
Yeah, I'm not joking. You'd be...
It's incredible, isn't it?
If you're, like, a regular match angler, and you're picking that up, if you put that down and go, no, I don't like it.
Yeah.
You're kidding yourself.
Yeah, that's right.
Or you're sponsored by somebody else.
Yeah, that's right. It's incredible.
Yeah.
It is incredible.
That is unbelievable. And that's interchangeable?
Interchangeable with the X5, X7 and the Pro. So it literally ticks all the boxes.
I think that's lovely.
It's amazing.
That really is lovely.
Now, what is impressive as well is I believe this is one of the best, if not the best, margin pole we've ever delivered to the market.
Yeah.
It is incredible. And, of course, it marries with the new range of poles as well.
I saw this pole a few months ago and I went to Tunnel Barn. It was a bit of a Shimano open day. No, Alex Bones was there and came down to me. Now, he's a bit better known for his feeder fishing, but all he said to me was, some new poles up there, Mark, have a look at the power margin. I'm like, really, Alex? He said, honestly, Mark, I've never seen anything like it for the money.
Wow factor.
And that is just
look
like...
That.
I mean, that's probably going to get you to the next platform on most commercials.
Yeah, exactly, and this is what it's all. Margin fishing is about fishing at reasonable nearing, but having a couple of sections behind you in case you hook a big fish, but having that power in the pole to play the fish with authority.
And, again, you've got aero joint.
All the spec of all the top of the range poles.
I'm telling you, best-selling margin pole of 2024.
Yeah, I'd agree with
in
that.
In my hands.
Yeah, 100% agree with that.
Right. Thank you for that, Nick.
My pleasure.
See you soon. Garbolino, new rods from Garbolino. I'm going to talk to Ian Giddings, who's an absolute star these days. Well, always have been, really.
I know. True.
So, look, we've got new sort of Garbo pellet Wagner rods.
Yep.
Tell us what it is and show us what they do, because they're quite clever,
okay.
These.
So, it is a 10.5 and 11.5 foot rod in one, without any little extension pieces or anything. So
no dolly button, nothing.
No dolly button, no pieces in the spigot there.
Right.
You literally just twist, extend it out, and that's your 11.5 foot there. And if you don't want it that, you just literally back in, lock it on.
So this is that's the longer one of the two, is it? This one's 10, 11, isn't it?
This is 10.5 to 11.
All right.
And a half.
Yeah.
So 10.5, 11.5.
Yeah.
Obviously, as it is there, you're at 10.5.
Yeah.
Obviously, no extension pieces in there. Just literally twist out to where you go, fully extend it, twist, just locks in place. You got an extra foot then.
It's a really thin blank as well, isn't it?
Yeah, it doesn't change. As soon as you extend that out, it doesn't change. It doesn't change the balance of the rod in any way. It's still well balanced.
And this is obviously a bit of reinforcing from when it's
that's obviously the bit of reinforcing. So when you just slide it back into there and lock it on.
And it's never going to stick.
It's never going to stick, and it's never going to come off loose either.
What sort of casting weight have we got with this then?
You'll be up to... up to 15 gram for that one, which is obviously normally your pellet waggler's what, 3, 4, 5 gram, so it's quite versatile up to a 15.
And because you can change, would that be like you'll change to the long rod on venue, or could you even do that during a match for a reason?
Well, you can simply do it during a match because obviously it doesn't affect your reel and your line because there's no eye there, so obviously you can. I suppose it's like. You imagine you're just fishing and it's flat calm, so you're fishing a 10.5 foot, the wind picks up, you need a little bit more punch behind it, simply extend.
So really what you could do then, if you're feeding you start quite short and you want to creep up...
You can
just go that bit further?
Conditions and if you need to just start going out a little bit further.
So that's got to be, really, it's a real money saver, isn't it?
Well, it's two rods in one, effectively. Yeah. You don't need to sort of have two 10-foot rods and two 11-foot rods set up. You've got it in one, so you might need two maybe set up.
I think it's a really clever thing. I'm sure that you've all looked at this when you've been fishing, because very often, if you're like pellet waggler fishing, they're hanging on the far side of the feed anyway. So you can start like you might think, oh, I'm struggling a bit.
Yeah, yeah,
pull
if
it
you
out,
just need to punch it that little bit
creep
further.
A bit
yeah.
further.
Yeah, 100%. Just literally, and it is split second.
What about pricing? What are we talking about?
These are retailing at £160, so it's a fair
sort of,
price for,
yeah, sort of
for a top
but,
end.
Yeah, but
rods.
I mean, you can see, I mean, they're like the fittings look nicely done, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, the blanks,
the
obviously,
blanks,
all, everything's
super slim.
Been redone. Everything's new, new blanks. New eyes, the lot been totally redesigned to previous ranges.
All right. If you like your pellet waggler fishing,
these are the ones to
that's
go
the thing
for.
To have a look at, yep. isn't it? We are at the ringer stand with a ringer. Oh, there's two of them now. That one's just gone. But you know, like Morecambe and Wise, isn't it? Karen and Richard Carpenter, Rob Wootton and his shadow.
Pete
Wootton. Right, we've got Ringers Duos. What's it all about then?
Yeah, these are a new product from Ringers. Duos, we do a pink and orange and a yellow and orange. Obviously, orange being the most successful colour
ever
over the last 10 years.
Ever.
Yeah, original and still the best.
Yeah.
And we've rolled them together and you've got these little beauties here.
Oh, they're nice. So, what's that? Well, hang on. What? So, we've got two sizes in
yeah,
here?
Yeah, we've got 6mm and 10mm in the same pot.
Right.
Bit of value. Obviously, everyone's looking for a bit of value
yeah,
these
yeah.
days. And two colours. If the water's really chocolate, these are working really, really well. And they're quickly becoming one of our best sellers.
Yeah, they've got a nice nose, haven't they?
Yeah, they've got a beautiful smell. And obviously, you won't be able to see it on film, but if you just give them a bit of a squeeze,
yeah, yeah,
you've actually got spongy, not too spongy, but absolutely perfect.
Yeah, that
the
is,
hair
look,
rigging.
Yeah, you're yeah. not. It's not going to split on
no,
you, is it?
Or bayoneting.
Yeah.
Bayoneting's all the rage.
So you get a bayonet through that?
Yeah, easy, yeah. Yeah,
yeah it's yeah. quite, actually, because I'm expecting that to split in half, and that's...
No. You've got a little bit of giving them, which are absolutely perfect. Obviously, the buoyancy is right. We're still using the...
What sort of hook are we talking about for this, then?
Size 10 QM1. We're still
right.
using the famous size 10.
Yeah,
in my
yeah.
opinion, you can use a bigger hook when using a wafter.
Right.
Because it takes the weight away.
Yeah, yeah.
So we always use a size 10 on a 6mm or a 10mm.
Right. And anything else new coming from Ringer soon that we should know about?
Not particularly
you?
Soon. Obviously, these haven't been out that long. We've got the Ringer's Chocolate Orange Micros. So your famous orange wafters.
Yeah, yeah.
Same flavour.
They are really quite a strong... You know,
yeah, very strong pungent smell and a
yeah.
very strong smell after you've soaked them as well. So if you wanna go down the orange range, you know, you can have orange micros, orange glaze, orange wafters.
Yeah. I think the thing always your ringers should be remembered is that all of you, or the three, let's say the three of you, you really do use
yes, we do.
Every
yeah,
product.
Yeah, yeah. And obviously the brand and the reputation has been if we don't use it, we don't want to sell it.
No.
So, and if we don't use it,
yeah,
we can't promote it.
As a company ethos, it doesn't really get any better than that, does it?
No. And we're going to continue to keep growing and growing.
Well, I shall leave you to sniff your stuff.
Lovely. Thank you very much.
So I'm here with Laura from Dragon Drinks, but although that has nothing to do with fishing tackle, it's a very, very serious subject that we're going to discuss. And my question to you is, why are you involved with angling?
We're involved with angling because the community are so welcoming. They're so great to be around. And for us as a brand, we're really wanting to get to talk to the ordinary person who just wants to do extraordinary things. And
yeah.
we feel like angling, that's what you do all day, every day. So
yeah.
for us, it's a really important community
so,
to work with.
I mean, it's been a long time since we've had somebody come into the industry that's not part of the industry.
Mm-hmm.
That's like, because you sponsor like the England...
We do, yeah, the GB Freestyle England team, yeah,
yeah.
And also the disabled team as well.
And it's just because you like how angling is and you thought, well, you know, that's somewhere we'd like to be involved?
It's partly that, but we also have a number of employees internally who also fish as well.
Okay.
So for us, it's really important that we kind of get our employees involved with everything. But on top of that, it's supporting things that they want to support.
All right.
So it's not just about kind of looking for things that, you know, have that kind of... I don't know, big impact. It's about supporting people on the ground. And
yeah.
that's why for our employees and for the people we work with, yeah, outside of that.
Yeah, because angling's not yeah. always viewed as a sexy sport. It's not like hardly an F1 car
hey,
racing,
don't
is
say
it?
That. Don't say that. Everyone's sexy in their own right.
So tell me something, then, about Dragon Drink.
So Dragon Energy, it came to the UK in 2019. We are the largest energy drink in South Africa by a country mile. We sold 500 million drinks last year.
Oh, my God.
And we have four flavours currently in the UK. You have the original, you have the sugar-free original, you have the tropical sugar-free, and you have the orange. And later this year, we'll expand to more drinks that you'll be able to try.
So you sell an incredible amount of this
huge
in South
amount.
Africa?
Yeah, we are, like I say, we're bigger than some of the largest competitors in the world
and
in South Africa.
So what about here in the UK? Like, do you have a distribution? You're just getting started in the UK?
We're definitely just getting started in the UK. But for us, at the moment, we're in all major airports and train stations. We're also in lots of different convenience stores. We're expanding into all the different kind of fishing retailers and fisheries up and down the UK, so you'll be able to buy us there. And then we're also in Iceland as well and on Amazon.
So I have an announcement out there for all you anglers. If you see this anywhere, buy it, because we need as many people as we can to support angling, and fair play to you for that.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
Welcome.
And we have arrived at one of the busiest stands at the show, and the orange carpet has probably given it away. This is the star that is Adam Rooney. And Guru have got new rods, haven't they?
We've got some new rods, mate, yeah.
Yeah, didn't see that coming, did I? Didn't see the poles coming,
no,
either.
No, we've kept it quiet, but we thought we'd save it for the show.
All right, so what are we looking at then, mate?
So basically what we've done is we've updated our N-Gage range. That's been out for a few years now.
True.
A few things in technology have moved on, so we brought out a new N-Gage Pro range.
Okay.
We've extended the range as well, because we feel like there's, from learning from the original range, there's rods that were missing, so we've added those to the range, and obviously we've done a range of poles as well.
So what we're looking at are commercial rods, or all-rounders, or natural rods?
To be honest,
or...
we've split it up this time, so we hope there's a little bit of something for everyone there.
Yeah.
So from sort of like commercial short rods through to distance feeder rods, from traditional wagglers to pellet waggler rods. So
right.
Yeah, we've got full range.
So because I think N-Gage is just more of a commercial type of rod, wasn't
it? Yeah, N-Gage
original?
Was very focused on commercial, to be honest. But obviously extending and what we've learned from Aventus and A-Class, we wanted to bring it into the pro range.
So as far as a blank build goes, what have you added pro-wise to these then?
So these are a higher grade of carbon than the original ones.
Yeah.
They're a totally different build throughout the three different groups, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah.
And we've used better components. So basically the rods will feel a little bit crisper.
Yeah.
We've also updated the quiver tips on the feeder rods, so they're a lighter carbon now with better quality rings, so they're more responsive and more reactive.
So with a lighter carbon quiver tip, are you getting a faster sort of post cast?
Yeah, so with a lighter, more responsive material, you get exactly that. So you get a crisper cast and a truer cast, so you've got less torque in the rod. And using lighter components, the rod will correct quicker.
Yeah. So. I take it these are like distance rods.
Yes.
Yeah, see, I'm sort of a bit old school with distance rods, so I quite like the fact that they're not super slim, because I think a fast taper blank
is very effective. Yeah,
definitely does what it's supposed to do. I know people go, "Oh, no, but it's not very thin." So no, because it's not going to work for you
exactly
as well as that blank.
When you go slim with a blank, you have to go thick in the blank to get the same response. But we prefer the fast taper, keep the carbon similar depth, so you get a nice balanced rod.
And it looks like you've actually thought about handle length as well, because I can see they're all different. Which is sort of, I always look at, when I look at that as a tackle edit, I think, well, yeah, these anglers have had hold of the rods. Because you can't, if you just go, that's the length handle we want, no, it's not.
Oh, no.
You need the handle to be the right length for the rod.
Everyone, even though these are mid-range and not our top range, you know, we've had Steve Ringer, Andy Bennett, Matt Godfrey, Frankie Gino Ginelli, all.
I've never heard of any of them.
No, nor have I, but they're meant to be really good at fishing.
Yeah, I did hear. I think maybe one of them I heard.
Yeah. But no, they've all influenced the rods, and obviously we've worked from our top end Aventus range down through to these to basically mimic exactly what we've done in that range, but at this price point and at that level of carbon.
Price point, where are we then?
Well, they start from, God, you're going to test me now.
Look at that.
So there we go, we've got a price list there. So the shorter feeders, the commercial feeders, are from 115 to 135.
Oh, that's a fair price.
Yeah, and then you're stepping up to the distance, which you've got a little bit, because obviously there's more carbon in there. They've got distance quiver tips, so they've got everything you need. And the float rods start from £99.
Right.
So very similar prices to the original range. But
improved.
An improved version.
What's your favourite?
My favourite out of all?
Yeah, go on, you've got to pick one.
You probably won't believe this, but I actually love this one here, which is the new 11-foot distance. So normally we've done like 11 foot in a standard feeder, but there's that big sort of Barston, Boddington areas where you're fishing the bomb a lot. And I feel like before in the range, we had a little gap there and we've really filled it with this rod.
I can see what you're on about the tip.
We put the distance tip on that. It's got the bigger rings. It's just a real lovely balanced rod. I mean, I'll be using this a lot, I think, in the next few years. It's a cracking bit
of kit. Yeah, it is a nice bit of kit.
So, yeah, that's my favourite.
All right, mate. Thank you for that.
You're very welcome. Thank you. Lovely to see you.
Like it was, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Thank you.